Hello students, today we are going to learn about the chapter Growth and Development and the different stages of growth and development. The objectives of this topic, growth and development, is to know about the growth and development and to understand the importance of growth and development and to know the differences between growth and development. And we are going to learn about various characteristics and aspects of growth and development. So to make this topic very clear to you, let me share the screen so that it will be very easy for you to understand the topic growth and development very easily, and you can also understand with the pictures and wherever the flow charts are there, you can understand the topic very clearly. So when you observe into this when you observe this chart, you can see there are different types of sizes, measurements, and you can see different types of people with the different types of professions. All this indicates that growth and development, both these terms are used interchangeably, and these terms relate to measurement of changes occurred in an individual after conception in the womb. Growth and development shows differentiation. However, both these terms used to denote the changes in human physical as well as functional behavior. Hence, growth and development can be used for any change brought about by maturation and learning, and essentially as a product of both heredity and environment. We can see from a fertilized egg to a full grown human adult, a person undergoes a cycle of changes brought about by process of growth and development in various dimensions. When you observe this flow chart, you can see thus dimensions like physical development, motor development, social development, intellectual development, and emotional development, aesthetic development, moral, and you can see vocational, language development. Likewise, there are different various dimensions you can observe in the development of whole child. When you come to the topic importance of growth and development, it is very, very important to identify the needs and the requirements of the children. It's a time for us to identify the needs and the requirements of the children, and the knowledge of growth and development will give us a complete scope to the parents and the teachers to identify the needs and the requirements of the children. Second is to diagnose any deviation from normal growth and development. If any deviation is there, we can easily diagnose if we have a knowledge about growth and development, and to prepare the child for all the changes which takes place physically and mentally, and also to assess the terms growth as well as development. And when you look into this assessment part of it, the assessment of growth and development is very, very helpful in finding out the state of health and the nutrition of the child. A continuous normal growth and development indicate a good state of health and nutrition of the child, whereas an abnormal growth or a growth failure is a symptom of disease. So we can see that there is a lot of difference between growth and development, and we are going to learn about what are the different factors which actually we stand as a differences between growth and development. Growth is quantitative. We can objectively measure them. We can observe them. So it is quantitative. Whereas development is qualitative. We cannot measure them. And growth does not continue throughout the lifespan. It stops after maturation. Whereas development, it is continuous in all areas of mental activity. It is one aspect of development, whereas a growth is a part of one aspect of development, whereas the development is a very, very complex. It has got many sided dimensions. Growth occurs at different parts of a body, whereas you can observe development are the changes which takes place in an organism. And here growth, it is not directional, whereas development, it is progressive and sequential. Growth, it is not uniform in all parts of a body, Whereas development rate, you can see it is also not uniform. The rate of development is not uniform. Sometimes it is low, sometimes it is in a peak stages, in a peak form. So here you can see that in a growth, like individual differences will exist. Some are short, some are tall, some are stout, some are thin. So growth, you can see that individual differences will exist. Whereas when you come to the development, children differ in development, in the levels of development. Growth is not affected by learning. Whether you learn or not, the growth takes place. You might have observed, I have done my PhD on mentally retarded children, that is children with mental challenges. So these children, whether they learn or not, physical growth will take place. So that's why we say it is not affected by learning. Whereas in the development, both learning and experience very important roles, and these learning and experience will affect the development. Growth may not lead to development, whereas you can see a most important point over here, that is, here the growth may not impact the development, but here you can see that last point, that is development is integrative, means development in one aspect promotes the development in other aspect. Development in one aspect will promote the development in other aspect. So let us look into the, there are different stages, and what are the different stages, which starts from mother's womb till old age. And these stages you can observe in the slide, that is, it starts from a prenatal period and it ends with the old age. The prenatal period from the conception to birth, and you can see that in infancy from birth to 3 years. The childhood, you can observe 3 to 12 years, and these 3 to 12 years are divided into 3 to 6 as an early childhood stage, and 6 to 12 years, it's nothing but later childhood stage. Coming to the adolescent stage, which starts from 12 years to 19 years, and that is nothing but from onset of puberty till attainment of maturity. Then coming to the adulthood, it starts from 19 years to 60 years, and old age or senescence age, we call it as from 60 years till to death. These are the different stages in the lifespan. Now let us discuss each development. Coming to the prenatal development, the fetus spends around 9 months in the womb, and this period is also called as prenatal development. So you can observe these are the picture also, right from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All these are the prenatal way, like in a mother's womb, like how many days the child is going to be, and what is the like a number of days, and what are the different types of characteristics which takes place in the prenatal development, you can observe. The time before the fetus comes out from the womb, we call it as antenatal period. And the postnatal period is nothing but after the child, immediately after the child contacts the environment, the postnatal period will start. That is nothing but immediately after the birth. This usually, the prenatal period, usually we can see that it begins right from the conception and ends at the birth, which approximately comes to 272 to 280 days or 9 calendar months. So you can observe that the following stages are divided into trimesters. How many? There are 3 trimesters. First trimester will start from 0 to 13 weeks, and second trimester starts from 14 to 26 weeks. Third trimester starts from 27 to 40 weeks. So here you can see that the first trimester is the most crucial for the baby's development. During this period, the baby's body structure and even the organ system will develop. Mother's body also undergoes major changes during the first trimester, that is from 0 to 13 weeks. Coming to the second trimester. Second trimester, it is nothing but 14 to 26 weeks, and you can observe that the second trimester of pregnancy is often called the golden period, because many of the unpleasant effects of early pregnancy disappears. There are so many unpleasant effects of early pregnancy we face, like vomiting sensation, reeling and all that. So they disappear slowly when they enter into the second trimester, that is nothing but the 14 to 26 weeks. So it is a golden period for a mother. Then coming to like somewhere between 16 to 15, 16 weeks to 20 weeks, the mother feels the baby's first fluttering movements. Then third trimester starts from 27 to 40 weeks. This is the final stage of pregnancy, and mothers are probably very excited, anxious for the birth of the baby. Some of the physical symptoms mothers may experience during this period include shortness of breath, they can find some uneasiness, hemorrhoids will develop, urinary incontinence, and you can also see varicose veins and sleeping problems will be occur. They may face no proper sleep, and this is very crucial and important stage for the mother. Now coming to the, these are all the stages of what I was talking about, the prenatal development, then the characteristics of the prenatal development. When you look into the characteristics of prenatal development, the first is the hereditary endowment is fixed during this prenatal development. And the favorable environmental conditions will foster. Greater growth and development will take place. Marked effect on the pattern of better development will form during the prenatal development. And also you can see attitude towards newly created individual will be formed by a mother. Wanting the child or don't wanting the child or whatever may be, the attitude is very, very important when we conceive during this prenatal period. What type of attitude you show towards your child when they are in the womb, it also matters, and it is going to have an impact over the child's development, growth and development. Next stage we are going to talk about, that is infancy, which starts from, usually the infancy stage starts from birth to 3 years. A part of it is prenatal, and then it ends with the third year, that is 3 years. So as we see here, it begins from birth and it extends till 3 years, and it is stage of rapid development. During the first 2 weeks, they are called as neonates. And by 6 months of age, infants are discriminated between the faces of the parents and the strangers. They can identify who is mother. Otherwise, whoever wears a sari, they treat them as a mom. For example, I'm saying. So now they can discriminate between who are parents, who are strangers. So they can discriminate between the known faces, familiar faces, and the unknown faces. And by the age of 9 months, a baby can creep. And in infancy stage, by 1 year of age, babies can associate sounds and say, can they say da da mama ba 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 ba, yeah, all those words, syllables, that is associated sounds, they will start saying that. At the age of 2 years, baby cooperates with others, especially adults, and later with his playmates. Infant is at utter helplessness at this stage, but it has a potentiality to grow and develop itself in physical, emotional, mental, and social matters. Now let us enter into the next stage, that is childhood. As we have already seen, the childhood is been divided into early childhood as well as late childhood. So the early childhood is nothing but the age group of 3 to 6 years. This roughly spans the period at the end of second year and the end of the fifth year. While the period of infancy is characterized as rapid growth, early childhood is stage of consolidation. This is also called as preschool period, where they are mostly dependent on mother than formal schooling. And preschool period, because mentally they are ready for the schooling and physically, mentally they are going to, school preparedness stage, Montessori, kindergarten, and early childhood school, all this easy. This is the stage where they will prepare their minds and the bodies for a school. This period is labeled by parents as a toy age. And usually this is also called as problem age or troublesome by some educators. They named it as a troublesome age. Psychologists, they described this age as a creative age or explorative age or imitative age. And this is the period of rapid growth and development, and you could see the dependence. Period to make belief and fantasy unsocial and emotionally unstable at this particular stage. Now coming to the I mean late childhood, that is the second part of our childhood, that is 6 to 12 years, they need and count on the friendly care and backing of his parents. Child makes an attempt to manage his own affairs, and you can observe that this period includes a period of slow and steady growth, independence, emotional stability and growth, developing social tendency, realistic attitude, and you can see the intellectual development will, these are the some of the characteristics. Coming to the next stage, that is adolescent stage, 12 to 19 years. The word adolescence has been derived from a Latin word adolescere, which means to grow or to grow to maturity. According to Elizabeth Herlock, 1981, adolescence begins when a children become sexually mature and ends when they reach the age of legal maturity. Puberty refers to the physical sexual maturation of boys and girls, and adolescence refers to the, here you can see, the behavioral characteristics of this period that are influenced by culture and physical changes. Adolescent period of transition from childhood to adulthood is called adolescence. Means this is a period where the transition takes place, where they need to shift from childhood. They have to stop all the childhood activities and slowly they need to enter into the adulthood stage. So this period is called transition period. The characteristics of adolescence period, you can observe, it is a transitional period and it's a time of change. As we all know that physically, physiologically, emotionally, all the changes will take place. And it is also called as problematic age, a time when the individual search for identity, recognition, etc. It's a dreaded age because various hormones will release. Suddenly, the child may not accept all the physical changes, psychological changes, physiological changes. It's a time of unrealism. And this is a stage where the threshold of adulthood will take place. Coming to the general characteristics of growth and development topic. All the characteristics, there are certain general characteristics like it is universal in nature. It occurs at the same time for every individual. And growth and development are interrelated. Brain maturation is directly proportional to physical health of the person. It is slow in childhood, speeds up in middle adolescent, and slower in the older age. So there is a certain common development or a characteristics belonging to every stage. A human being shows a peculiar quantitative and qualitative changes in his body and behavior, with the help of which we can say at what particular age an individual belongs to and to which definite stage of his life. I mean, we can have an idea what are the different types of changes which takes place in an every individual. In the following pages, we will try to understand the characteristics of child and an adolescent. For example, you can observe that I'm going to start from early childhood because you can have the school. This is nothing but where the child enters into Montessori schooling and kindergarten schooling. So we are concerned as BE program, we are concerned about right from kindergarten stage, what are the different types of physical developments, intellectual development, social development, and emotional developments will take place. So when you look into the developmental characteristics of early childhood, the first part, that is physical development, physical growth is at slow rate. Physical growth is at slow rate. The average annual height is 3 inches. By the age of 6, average child measures 46.6 inches. Okay. The average annual increase in weight is 3 to 5 pounds. And at age of 6, child weight approximately 7 times as much they did at birth. The muscles become very larger, stronger, heavier. The baby teeth begin to be replaced by permanent teeth. The child in preschool stage develops a variety of motor skills like walking, running, jumping, hopping, climbing. So like that, all that psychomotor domain type of skills will develop. Then coming to the intellectual development of the childhood and adolescence. At the early childhood, child enters into the Piaget's second stage of cognitive development, pre-operational stage. Child begins to think symbolically. Child develops the perceptions of, the size of, size of it, shape, color, time, distance. All these concepts will develop, perceptions will develop. Creativity and imagination begin to grow. Then thinking and reasoning develops in relation to the materials. Span of attention and interest in exploring the environment increases. Then developmental characteristics of child and an adolescent, you can see with respect to social development, early childhood is named as pre-gang age, the time when children are learning the foundation of social behavior. Pre-gang age, before formation of a gang, pre-gang age. So slowly they develop into different types of gangs. So now you can see the pairing, cliques, and all these type of, social relationships will develop. Children have one or more favorite playmate with which they communicate their feelings, emotions, interests. Children identify themselves with the group by imitation, mostly by imitation. They try to identify the group. Then children develop interpersonal and sex appropriate relationship with others. Feeling of autonomy develops in children. They begin to explore their environment independently. Social environment expands beyond home. So now you can slowly, you can see that the child move from home conditions to the, you can say they go to the playground, they will get connected with the different types of agencies of the community. Slowly the child will get connected with the other types of, social interactions. Then you can see emotional development. Children indulge in temper tantrums. The emotions are spontaneous and emotions are expressed in relation to concrete objects. And child shifts his emotions very rapidly. Thus, emotions are temporarily, you can see emotions are very temporary and they're not very permanent. Emotional expressions are intense, irrespective of the intensity of the stimulus. Children fail to hide their emotions. They cannot hide their emotions. They express them through their different activities like crying, nail biting, thumb sucking, speech difficulties. So these are all the temper tantrums. You can see that they're emotionally, they're not going to hide them. They will express immediately. So with this knowledge, we are supposed to, as teachers and the parents, we are supposed to observe such behaviors and we should understand that the child got emotionally disturbed. That's what the knowledge we are supposed to take from this text or a lecture. Then coming to the language development, children have strong motivation to learn, speak, because learning to speak is an essential tool in socialization. Compared to the animals, the only difference between, the language is the only difference where we can say that the communicating abilities makes us more socialized personalities. Certain sounds and the sound combinations are especially difficult for a child to learn to pronounce. Children's vocabulary increases rapidly as they learn new sounds and new meanings for old words. So this is a time where we have to expose them to the new vocabulary, new words, new pronunciations. After age 3, the child forms 6 to 8 word sentences containing all parts of speech. So we're not supposed to expect anything beyond this because biological maturity, psychological maturities are more important to note down by parents and the teachers. Too much of aspirated parents or the teachers will expect more from the students. We are not supposed to do that. 6-year child speaks more like adults with a few errors. Of course, this is the stage. And psychological characteristics of adolescence where we can observe that it is in a transitional period. Children, they go from childhood to adulthood, putting away childish things, kiddish things, and they must learn new patterns of behavior. You can also see it is a problem age. They cannot act either as a child or as an adult. Sometimes we treat them as a child. Sometimes we treat them as adult. This will always make the child more confusing. They cannot accept the roles as a child or as an adult. Adolescence is a time of search for identity. Child began to crave for identity, craving for recognition. So here you can observe that teachers and the parents, all of us, we are supposed to give them such a place where all the time we have to identify them, we have to lay, we have to call them by names, we have to appreciate them, we have to provide them the rewards. So because this is the stage where they search or crave for the identity and are no longer satisfied to be like their peers in every respect. This is the stage they want to be different. Then you can see that adolescence is nothing but adolescence is the period of storm and stress, a time that heightened emotion tension. And adolescence is essentially a hero worshiper. You can observe adolescents keeping cricketers, film heroes, political leaders, all they are the hero worshippers for this stage. Then sex consciousness becomes too intense. Then you can see peer group relationship is too much intense. They follow the group norms. You can see the period of daydreaming. They exhibit exuberant imagination, very wild imagination. Adolescence is a period of acquiring the attitude and the values, interests, likes, dislikes, which are essential for their effective participation in society. Then coming to the physical development, physical growth reaches its peak and you can see the body take its final form. The glands, that is all the endocrine glands, they become active, they produce increased amounts of hormones. Individual attains biological maturation, which is accompanied by the appearance of secondary sexual characteristics. Facial whiskers, hair in the forearms, legs, chest begin to appear. So externally, all these changes will take place. Adolescents, regardless thereof sex, are conscious of physical appearance. You can see long standing before mirrors, and they'll become more conscious about their appearance, physical appearance. Coming to the social development, onset of puberty is an early in girls. The first menstruation occurs at the age of 12 to 13 years. For some, it may vary due to individual differences or maybe because of the nativity or some other factors. Boys reach puberty at about age of 14. The signs of onset of puberty among boys are the appearance of pubic hair, hair in the armpit, face, forearms, chest, legs, etc. And the other signs are the occurrence of nocturnal emissions and baking of the voice. That voice will become harsh. Autoerotism, you can observe both boys and girls, they fall in love with each other. They try to take a pleasure from their own bodies. Self-decoration, as I told, admiring before the mirrors are the common practice. Self-enjoyment by indulging in the masturbations is prevalent at this age. Homosexuality at this stage, boys and girls are attracted to the members of their own age. That means beginning of the adolescent stage, they are together, homosexualities, the girls with the girls and boys with the girls, they make a friendship. But later on, you'll see that they'll make a friendship with the opposite sex, that is nothing but heterosexuality, where boys and girls are interested to make friendship or establishing even sexual relationship with the members of opposite sex. Intellectual development, it is a period of great intellectual development. According to the Piaget, this is a stage of formal operations, which is characterized by the ability to think abstractly. And adolescent can persist his thoughts logically. The person keeps an abstract idea in mind as hypothesis and stresses its consequences to know the facts. An adolescent's power of imagination, memory, critical thinking, observation also increases. Coming to the social development, adolescence is a period of conformity. Hero worship develops, as we have already discussed this. They admire their heroes and also try to identify with ideals in the modes of dressing, hairstyle, mannerisms, body language. Adolescence is a period of establishing heterosexual relationship. Group loyalty, that's the most important quality. You can see that among adolescents. A feeling of social responsibility develops during this stage. Adolescence is characterized by emotional instability, intensity. It is a period of heightening of all emotions. We might have observed they're not constant in emotional expression. Sometimes they say, I love you. Sometimes I say, I hate you. Within no time gap, they say, we love you, mom. We love you, teacher. Within no time, they go away from you. So this type of inconsistency in their emotional expression, you can observe. Adolescents can express their emotions in relation to abstract things also. They develop competencies to bear tensions in different social situations. And adolescents are often confused by the rapid bodily changes which create unexpressed fears and feelings of guilt. So now coming to the, what are the major four factors you can observe over the screen? These are the factors that promotes the development. One is good nutrition, good emotional support, providing them a good play, then a training, that is language training. Teacher and parents play a very, very significant roles. It is only with the knowledge of growth and development of the learner at every stage of his life, it is possible for a teachers to provide a proper guidance and counseling and arrange learning situations and plan instruction programs for bringing desirable harmonious development in their personalities. So we have seen different types of stages and different types of various characteristics of different stages. We have seen the differences between growth and development. With this, I finally conclude my lecture with the educational implications and the significance. What is the role of parents and the teachers? We need to bear in mind the individual variations in growth and school programs must be adjusted, tailored, modified according to the needs and the requirements of the children. Good physical growth through the provision of good playground, that is games, indoor games, outdoor games, sports. Teachers and the parents, they should help in cultivating the among the pupils the habits of balanced nutrition, balanced eating. All these are the important things we have to take care of. And providing various co-curricular activities must be like there. They need to introduce various types of co-curricular activities. I mean, because without co-curricular activities, there won't be channelizing, I mean, all these energies in a positive direction. So we need to have an integrated curriculum where the curricular and the co-curricular activities need to be balanced. Teachers and parents should not demand pupils what is beyond the stage of growth. Already I emphasized on this point, please don't expect the child beyond his biological maturity and psychological maturity, don't expect that much from the child. That may create a guilt of failure or guilt of not getting the correct grade or rating or a prize, whatever may be, that may again affect the further growth and development. In conclusion, I can say that it is only with the knowledge, of the growth and development of a learner at every stage of his life, it is possible for a teacher to render a proper guidance and arrange a learning situations and arrange a learning experiences, and also to plan instructional programs to bring a desirable, means all the desirable harmonious, environment can be provided by this. The task of formal as well as informal education is to help him in his path of growth and development. Therefore, it is imperative that the individuals supposed to be connected with the task of helping the child to grow, develop satisfactorily, and must be acquainted with the nature of growth and development. In conclusion, knowledge of these principles of growth and development may prove quite useful to the parents and teachers for ensuring harmonious growth and development of personalities of their children. Fine. This is the way I conclude my lecture. Like we are supposed to plan the proper instructional programs with the good co-curricular activities and the curricular activities, the right time at the right stage. Every parent need to have a knowledge about the growth and development. Every teacher is supposed to have the knowledge of growth and development so that we can provide and facilitate the proper growth and development of the child. Thank you very much.